SI Group Technologies would like to thank you for your purchase of the Viper One pre-treatment machine. We want to show you some of the simple ideas and concepts on how you can make your Viper One work and operate at its most optimum performance to give you the best white DTG prints you could possibly get from your pre-treating and your direct-to-garment printer. To adjust your Viper One pre-treatment machine and to vary the amount of fluid that's laid down onto your garment, you will use the spray adjustment knob. That is the center knob right here, and its whole function is to determine how much air is let into the air cylinder and how fast, which will then result in how fast your spray head moves. When it comes out of the box, your Viper One is set to the home position, okay? What that means is the spray head won't move, or it'll move extremely slowly. That is in generally the 12 o'clock position, and if you rotate your knob slightly counterclockwise and then rotate it back, you'll notice that it meets a little bit of resistance. When you start hitting that resistance, you don't want to over tighten this knob. That can actually over tighten the valve and completely shut everything off. When you home it, that at that position, basically that is your zero out position. That's right when you hit a little bit of resistance. From that point, you can refer to the spray laydown chart that's located in your user manual or online at our tech support site. And this manual contains a chart that shows the number of turns and how that correlates to the amount of fluid applied to the garment. Now, in our case here, we'll use for an example, we are at the home position. If we turn this one full turn open, and that would be counterclockwise, as you can see here, it shows less and more on the face dial. More meaning if I close it, the spray bar is going to move slower, which means it's going to apply more fluid or more pretreatment to the garment. By opening it counterclockwise, like we're going to do here, one full rotation, we're actually applying less fluid because we're allowing more air into the system and it'll run quicker, laying down less fluid. So one full turn will give us about 30 grams to 31 grams of fluid on the shirt. Now, most people that would use 30 grams would be roughly the brother crowd that have the brother garment printers. For most of the other machines, it would be possibly significantly less. However, a lot of that all depends. We get this question all the time, is how much fluid should I apply to my shirt? Where should I set my machine? I don't have a good answer for you on that. And the whole reason why is because each garment printer, each pre-treatment that's used, and each shirt and shirt color will vary depending on the amount of fluid that it needs to give you the best results for your white ink garment prints. Now, that sounds a little bit like a cop-out, but it's not. The general rule of thumb is the darker the shirt, the more pre-treatment you're going to need. The heavier weight the shirt, generally, the more pre-treatment you'll need. On the other hand, conversely, if you're using a lighter colored garment, you can lay down less pre-treatment, as well as a lighter garment, lighter weight garment, like a, say, a 4 or 5 or 5.5 ounce shirt, will require less fluid because you can't apply the same amount of fluid. It'll just be puddled onto the platen, and it's not going to do the shirt any good. So, general rule of thumb, the darker and the heavier the shirt, the more pre-treatment you'll want to apply to the garment. The lighter the color and the lighter the weight the shirt, the less pre-treatment. So if we wanted to lay down less pre-treatment, let's say about 16 grams, I can look at my chart and see that three full rotations would be about 15 to 16 grams of fluid. Now, if I forgot where this is set at, all I have to do is rotate it back counterclockwise or clockwise to the home position when I meet just a little bit of resistance. And then I can open it up three full turns. In this case here, one, two, three. The machine is now set so that it'll apply about 15 to 16 grams of fluid consistently every time I load a shirt and press the start button.